Hello friends, welcome to anujindal.in. So in this video I am going to discuss some numerical questions from the topic of share capital. Okay, so you know in SEBI grade examination there is a paper 2 in the general stream, and that paper 2 consists of 6 subjects. So commerce and accountancy is one of those 6 subjects. Okay, so let us discuss the questions one by one. Question number 1, it says preference shares amounting to rupees 1 lakh are redeemed at a premium of 5% by issue of shares amounting to rupees 50,000 at a premium of 10%. The amount to be transferred to capital redemption reserve account will be. So you have to tell how much amount will be credited or how much amount will be transferred to CRR, capital redemption reserve. Okay. So basically there is a rule that if you look at the preference shares, so the preference shares have a face value of rupees 1 lakh. Okay. They have a face value of rupees 1 lakh and they have to be redeemed at a premium of 5%. So we are not concerned here with the premium. So premium you can ignore. We are only concerned with the face value. And out of this 1 lakh, 50,000 rupees are raised from issue of shares. So shares worth rupees 50,000 face value, okay, are issued. And these shares are issued at a premium. Again, we are not concerned with the premium here. We are only concerned with the face value. So we have to redeem shares, preference shares worth rupees 1 lakh. Okay. And we have issued new shares of 50,000. Okay. Now, what is the remaining face value? What is the remaining amount of face value? So the remaining amount is 50,000. And this remaining amount, 50,000, has to be transferred to the CRR account. Basically, the rule says that apart from the money raised from the issue of shares, so the company has raised 50,000 plus the premium, but premium we have to ignore. We have to only consider the face value. So 50,000 face value shares have been raised. Okay, the remaining amount is 50,000. So this amount will be transferred to the capital redemption reserve account. So let us assume in this particular question no shares are issued. So in that case the whole 1 lakh would have to be transferred to the capital redemption reserve account. So in this particular question the answer will be option B, rupees 50,000, it will be transferred to capital redemption reserve account. And similarly in this particular question, let us say shares of rupees 1 lakh were issued, then in that case no amount will be transferred to capital redemption reserve account. Okay, I hope this is very clear. Now question number 2, it says Zebra Limited invites applications for 50,000 shares for which rupees 2 per share is payable on application. Okay, applications were received for 80,000 shares and 50,000 shares are allotted on pro rata basis to the applicants for 70,000 shares. You have to calculate the excess application money from X. So there is a person or there is an applicant X who was allotted 200 shares. So you have to calculate how much extra application money has been received from this applicant X. Now, if you read this question carefully, rupees 2 per share is payable on application. Okay. Applications were received for 80,000 shares and out of this 80,000 shares, 70,000 applicants, shares for 70,000 applicants, they were allotted 50,000 shares and the rest 10,000 applicants, they were rejected. Okay, this is the implicit information. This is not given explicitly, but this is the implicit information that 10,000 shares applicants were rejected. So the ratio is those who applied for 7 shares, they were allotted 5 shares. So 7:5 is the allotment application ratio, application allotment ratio. Okay. Now you are given X and X was allotted 200 shares. Okay. X was allotted 200 shares. So first of all, we need to calculate that x applied for how many shares. So you can calculate it by 200 into 7 by 5. So if you multiply 200 by 7 upon 5, you will get the number of shares applied by x. So simply you can calculate it. This is 280. So 280 shares were applied. So x applied for 280 shares, but he was allotted 200 shares because the ratio is 7:5. I hope this is very, very clear. So in this particular question, x applied for 280 shares, right? So he must have paid application money on these 280 shares, which is 560 rupees. Okay. But he was allotted only 200 shares. So he should have given application money of only 400 rupees. So 160 rupees, 560 minus 400. So 160 rupees, which is the extra application money. Okay. This is basically, you can say 80 extra shares or 80 extra shares applied into 2 is equal to 160 rupees. So 160 is the excess application money received from X. So option A is the correct answer. Rupees 160 was the excess application money received from X. I hope this is very, very clear. So the important thing is calculating the ratio, the application allotment ratio. Now next is question 3. E Limited had allotted 10,000 shares to the applicants of 14,000 shares on pro rata basis. So first of all, you can calculate the ratio 14:10, which is equal to 7:5. Again, the ratio is 7:5 as in the previous question. The amount payable on application is rupees 2. F applied for 420 shares. Now there is an applicant. He applied for 420 shares. So you can easily calculate how many shares he was allotted. So 420 into 5 by 7, because 7 is the application and 5 is the allotment. Okay. So 420 into 5 by 7, this will come out to be 300. So he was allotted 300 shares. The number of shares allotted and the amount carried forward for adjustment against allotment money. So first of all, we have to calculate the number of shares allotted. It is 300. We have calculated. Now we also need to calculate the amount carried forward for adjustment against allotment. So extra shares applied by him is 120. Okay. And amount payable on application is rupees 2 per share. So excess money given on application is rupees 240, which will be adjusted against the allotment. So the correct answer is option D. 300 shares, he was allotted 300 shares, and 240 is the excess application money, which will be adjusted against the allotment money due. I hope this is very, very clear. The correct answer is option D. Now moving on, question number 4. P, to whom 100 shares of rupees 10 each were allotted at par, paid the application money of rupees 2 and allotment money of rupees 4 per share. Okay. He did not pay the call money of rupees 4 per share. So the division of 10 rupees, which is the face value, is 2 rupees on application, 4 rupees on allotment, and 4 rupees on call. Okay. He has not paid the call money of 4. Okay. His shares were forfeited. The amount to be credited to share forfeiture account. Now his shares were forfeited because he did not pay the call money. But he has already paid the application and allotment money, which is 2 plus 4, 6 rupees. Okay. So 6 rupees he has paid on 100 shares. So 100 into 6 is 600. So 600 rupees he has already paid, and this is the amount which will be forfeited and credited to share forfeiture account. So answer is option C, rupees 600. I hope this is clear. So basically, what will be the journal entry in this particular question? The journal entry will be share capital account debited to shares forfeited account to calls in arrear. And what will be the amount? So share, so 10 rupees were called up. Okay. So 100 into 10, it comes out to be 1000. Now shares forfeited, it comes out to be rupees 600, 100 into 6. and calls in arrear is 100 into 4, 400. So share capital account debited to shares forfeited to calls in arrear. This will be the journal entry. I hope this is very, very clear. Now moving on to the next question. Question 5. Q Limited forfeited 500 shares of 10 each, rupees 8 called up, on which the shareholder has paid application money of rupees 3 and allotment money of rupees 2. Out of these 500 shares, 200 shares were reissued as fully paid up for rupees 8 per share. So what amount of forfeited shares account is transferred to capital reserve? So let me explain you this question in detail. So basically 8 rupees were called up by the company. Okay. And out of this 8 rupees, 3 rupees have not been paid. So this is 3 rupees is the calls in arrear. Rupees 3 is the calls in arrear. Okay. So 5 rupees have already been paid up and 3 rupees have not been paid up. So 500 shares are forfeited. Okay. So what will be the journal entry for this share capital account debit? It will be debited by 500 into 8, which will be equal to 4000. Okay. To shares forfeited account. So shares forfeited account, what will come? 500 shares into 5, which is 2500. To calls in arrear. Okay. To calls in arrear. This will be 500 into 3, which is 1500. So this will be the journal entry. I hope this is very, very clear to you. Now, out of the 500 shares which have been forfeited, 200 shares are reissued. Okay. And you have to remember that this shares forfeited amount, 2500, this is 500 shares into 5. So 5 rupees per share was received by the company. So the maximum discount which can be given by the company on reissue, it is also 5. Okay. So the company cannot give more discount than the amount which has been forfeited. Okay. So these 200 shares, they have been reissued at rupees 8 per share, which means 2 rupees discount has been given per share. Okay. So in capital reserve, how much amount will we transfer? So basically the formula, or basically how to calculate the amount to be transferred to capital reserve. So you will consider only 200 shares because only 200 shares are reissued. So on 200 shares, the company has received 5 rupees. So 200 into 5, 1000. So 1000 is the amount in the shares forfeited account for 200 shares. And discount which has been given on reissue is rupees 2. So 400, 200 into 2 is 400 rupees discount. So 1000 minus 400 comes out to be 600. So 600 rupees will be transferred to the capital reserve. So we transfer to the capital reserve only for those shares which have been reissued. This you have to remember. Okay. So the correct answer is rupees 600, option C. I hope this is very, very clear to you. Now moving on to the next question, question 6. So let us read the question. Z Limited forfeited 150 shares of rupees 10 issued at a premium of rupees 2 for non-payment of the final call of rupees 3. So the face value of the share is rupees 10. Okay. 3 rupees has not been paid and 3 rupees is the final call, which means that 7 rupees has already been received by the company because 10 rupees is the face value. Okay. Of these, 100 shares were reissued at the rate of 11 per share. So the shares have been reissued at premium. So there is no discount. Okay. How much would be transferred to capital reserve? So on 150 shares, the company has received 7 rupees per share, which has been forfeited. So this comes out to be rupees 1050. Now there is no discount on the reissue. So this entire amount of 1050 rupees will be transferred to the capital reserve account. So the correct answer is option C, rupees 1050. I hope this is very, very clear to you. Okay. Now the last question, question 7. J Limited reissued 2000 shares which were forfeited by crediting share forfeiture account by rupees 3000. These shares were reissued at rupees 9 per share. The amount transferred to capital reserve will be. Now, if you look at the question carefully, 3000 is the amount in the share forfeiture account, and the number of shares which were forfeited is 2000. So it comes out to be 1.5 rupees per share. So the amount which has been forfeited is rupees 1.5 per share. Okay. And the discount which has been given on the reissue, it is 10 minus 9. It is rupees 1 per share. So rupees 1 per share discount has been given by the company on reissue. Okay. So which means, how much amount will be transferred to capital reserve? It will be 1.5 minus 1 into the number of shares, which is 2000. Okay. So it will be 0.5 into 2000, which is the number of shares. It is equal to 1000. So 1000 rupees will be transferred to the capital reserve. So the correct answer is option C, rupees 1000. So I hope, friends, you must have liked this video. I have tried to cover as many questions from different areas as possible from the topic of accounting for share capital. So if you have liked this video, then do subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon to get regular notifications and updates. All the very best, friends. If you have any doubt or query, you can always ask in the comment section. All the very best. Have a nice day.